हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज संपदा कुलकर्णी फ्रॉम टेक टॉक्स। हियर इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ सर्क्युलर क्यू डेटा स्ट्रक्चर। फ्रॉम द सर्क्युलर क्यू डेटा स्ट्रक्चर वी हैव गॉन थ्रू मेनी ऑफ द कंसेप्ट्स एज मेंशन बिलो। इफ यू वॉन्ट द मोर डिटेल्स अबाउट दैट, यू कैन गो थ्रू द प्ले लिस्ट ऑफ द सर्क्युलर क्यू। एंड नाउ इन दिस करंट वीडियो I am covering the concept of insert function in C++. So dear friends, before moving to the contents, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Now let's start with the circular queue operation, where that insert operation I am going to explain you in the concept with respect to C++ programming. First of all, you must know that these two functions we can perform, these two operations we can perform on a circular queue. The first one is insert, or it is also called as enqueue operation, where while performing insert or enqueue operation, we suppose to check whether the circular queue is full or is it overflowing. And the second operation is nothing but delete or dequeue operation. While performing delete or dequeue operation, we supposed to check whether the circular queue is empty or underflow. How to perform all these operation and how to insert or delete the element from a circular queue, that I am going to explain you in these two consecutive video sessions. So first of all, in this current video, let's start with the insert operation C++ program. First of all, let's start with the insertion algorithm step by step. So the first step is, let's check whether the queue is full or not. While checking the queue is full or not, we are going to check it with the help of operation like the rare plus 1 modulo 10. Let's consider this is the size of the queue, and if it is equal to front, then let's say the queue is full. There is another also way available to check the queue is full or not. So let's start with the program. So this is the function enqueue, which is helpful to add the data or to insert the element into the queue. Let's consider this is the enqueue function, for which we are passing a parameter integer value, which we supposed to pass into the function. So let's start with the function. First condition, we supposed to check whether the queue is full or not. Let's jump to the queue full checking function. Its return type is boolean. Whether if the queue is full, I am going to return the value true, otherwise I am going to return the value false. So this is the first way with which we can check whether the queue is full or not. Let's check if my front is equal to 0 and if my rear is at size minus 1 position, it indicates that my queue is full, and let's return the true value. But this condition is not sufficient, as this is the circular queue. My front can be at any of the position and rear should be at its previous position. This also the condition with which we can say that the queue is full. So that position we can check with the help of if my front is just next to the rear, it indicates that my queue is full. But instead of checking these two conditions, I can use a single condition where I will check whether my front is equal to rear plus 1 modulo size. So if my front is at the next position, by applying this formula, it indicates that my queue is full. It will return a true value and this condition is true. After returning back from this boolean is full function, it will return back and it indicates that the function is returning value true. If the condition is true, then what we have to do, we have to display a message queue is full and we supposed to exit from the enqueue function. But now let's consider this condition is false, queue is not yet full. What we have to do, we have to go to the step number 2. While moving to the step number 2, we supposed to check whether we are inserting the first element in Q or not. How we are going to check that? By checking the condition front is equal to minus 1. Because initially when the Q is empty, we are initializing front to minus 1. If this condition is true, it indicates that the Q is currently empty and this is the inserting element is nothing the first element. So while inserting the first element, we have to initialize both front and rear to 0th position. So now let's perform this thing practically. So if the condition is false, let's consider the condition is false, Q is not full, where we have to go? We will return back from this is full function with the value false. This condition if is going to become false and it will go into the else part. So in this else part, what we have to do, we have to check the condition whether the front is equal to minus 1. It indicates that my element, inserting element is the first element. So for that, what we have decided? We have decided to initialize both front and rear to 0th position. So we have done that. Now let's move forward. We have initialized both front and rear to 0th position. After that, we have to actually insert the element at the 0th position. So let's move forward for the inserting element wala step, where at the in the array at the rearth position we are going to insert a new element. Let's perform the same task practically, where in this array at the rearth position we are inserting the element x which we have passed, which where x is holding the value which we are going to insert or nq into the circular queue. So with this statement, we are inserting the element at the rearth position and we are displaying a statement like this element, x element is inserted in our queue. Now after this, now let's consider the inserting element is not the first element, means this condition is false. Let's move to the else part. What we have to do in this condition, we have to move round and round by performing the circular increment with the formula, and let's insert the element at the rearth position. So this same condition let's implement practically. So if this condition is false, that is front is not at the minus 1 position, means we have inserted few elements into the queue initially. So we'll go into the else part, and else we will perform the circular increment by performing round and round concept. And here this is the formula where we supposed to move forward circularly to the next position. If you want more details about all these things, then I have already explained all these things in my previous video. Now insert the element at the rearth position, and after inserting we are going to display a message inserted x element into the circular queue. So friends, I hope you must have understood the concept of the insert or nq function while checking the condition is full and we have inserted the value successfully into the circular queue. So thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment. Here I am providing you subscription link. Please do subscribe my channel. Along with this, I am providing you the whole playlist of Circular Queue along with the next video of this video series. Thank you. Happy data structuring. Happy learning. Thank you.